Hey everybody, what's up? What's good? It's me. I got my emotional support, Rilakkuma, with me. I got my favorite beverage of all time. I swear they gotta still be putting cocaine in this because there's literally no reason why, you know, I should be this addicted to this stuff. But anyway, today we're cracking open a cold one with the boys and the non-binaries. And the femmes, and the questionings, and the gender fluids. We're cracking open a cold one with everybody. And today, we're gonna talk about one of my biggest pet peeves, which has to do with grammar and pronunciation. This is not a video to make anybody feel stupid, okay? Just to start this video off, I just want you guys to know, I, for a long time, and I had written like novels and stuff, and literally I thought for a long time that the word detrimental meant the opposite of what it means. I thought that it meant like necessary. Like, I feel like the thing is like it can, I feel like it sounds like that. Like, oh, that was detrimental to your health. Like, I mean, I guess like if you think of like the word debt, that makes more sense. But like to me, it always sounded like a good, important word. Like, oh, it's important to your health. No, it means it's bad. Like it will destroy, like it means like it will destroy it. It's detrimental. It's like a plague on you. Like it doesn't mean that. So I just wanted to, a lot of it's going to do with like proper usage of words. Because here's my thing, like, I don't know, once again, growing up, like everybody telling me I'm stupid, it really bugs me when like I go out of my way to like educate myself on stuff, and then like people want to argue with me and they don't even know how to like pronounce words or spell or use proper grammar. And I'm just like, I don't want to be that person who says that like your argument is invalid if you don't know those simple things, because that's not true. Like, I could understand if English was your second language, like that's an acceptable reason. But like, literally, I'm so sick and tired of like native speakers of English, like getting their own language wrong. Like I just said, I've done it, but I feel like there's a difference between like not knowing something and, you know, having done everything within your power to try to know about it and just not caring and, yeah, just not caring. Like, I feel like there's a difference between those things. So it's like, you know, so I am actually, and also I just want to say like my other thing is I'm going to start off with like a really big pet peeve, and it actually has to do with the pronunciation of a word from another language. Because the only reason it bothers me so much, and like, I don't know, like it does kind of bother me when I'm listening to like cases about like foreign stuff and people like pronounce like Japanese or foreign names in like the most English accent. Like it just, and I don't mean like British, I mean like being like Naruto and Kasumi and like, you know, like super, like just, you're like, guys, that's not even how they say it on the show. Oh, honestly, no, like that was actually the reason why at first, like I was watching that new Grudge series, and I'm not even kidding. The dub was so bad. Like, as soon as they started pronouncing all of the Japanese names super American, like it bothered the fuck out of me. And I was like, nope, we're watching it with subs, all subs, because I can't do this. So and I also have a handy dandy child's toy, because like apparently, like, I don't know, people can't figure out shit from words. They need it like, you know, put in front. So the first word we're gonna work on is Nganga. Oh shit, I forgot. It's all gonna be backwards. Oh well. But the first word we're gonna work on is Nganga. Okay? So apparently, everybody in the whole world, you know, who covers the Adolfo Constanzo murder case, does not, for some weird reason, want to look up how to say the word Nganga. And, you know, that's what also really, really, really bugs me when people pronounce words wrong, because a lot of it is just like sounding out the word. Like, I could understand if it was like a super long word and no one ever uses it. Like, okay, no one ever uses Nganga, but like, it's fucking six letters, guys. Like, and it's not even different. Like, the first half is the same as the second half. You literally sound it out, people. Like, Nga, Nga, Nganga. Like, how is that difficult? Like, I'm sorry. Like, I'm not trying to make people feel stupid, like I said, but like, I have to say it. Dictionary.com is a free app. Like, okay, once again, that's a foreign word, so I'm letting that one go. But it's hard to also let it go because, like I said, it's six letters and like three, like half of the word is literally the same thing as what you already just said. So like, just sound out the fucking word, people. Like, I don't know. It's just so funny that people will be like reading and they see a word they don't know and they're like, I'm not even going to try to pronounce that. And I'm like, really? Like, for real? The next word is heinous. Heinous. Say it with me. Heinous. It's not heinous. And I'll show you why it's not heinous. Lord Jesus in heaven, if you're going to do a freaking true crime thing and say something is heinous, maybe you should at least know how to spell it and say it. So I will show you why it is not heinous. We're gonna sound out the word again, guys, like we're in second freaking grade. Because, like, I'm sorry, but that's why it's my pet peeve, because like, it's so easy to figure out how to pronounce things. You literally sound it out, and if that doesn't work for you, you double check with the dictionary.com app, because it will literally pronounce words for you. Like, I'm sorry, but do you understand why this is so irritating? Okay, I will explain to you why it is not heinous. 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 It's not he-nee. Like, the I is not over here, people. The I is not after the end. It's not hey-nee. It's heinous. Heinous. Not heinous. Heinous. Not heinous. Heinous. Not heinous. Okay? Sorry. Not trying to make you feel dumb. It's just like, you sound dumb. Like, I'm not saying you are dumb, but you sound like you are. And I don't want people to think you are if you're not. So, okay. And we're going to do some real easy. Okay, no. Yeah, okay. We're going to do some real easy ones there. Speaking of there, that's what we're going to do next. Welcome to my English class. Because I literally cannot stand how people just don't understand. Refers to a place. He is over there. Refers to possessing something. That is theirs. Is a contraction for they are. They're very nice. How fucking easy is that? Like, how easy is that? It's so easy. And your is even easier. Like, this is difficult. I have to like look through this little peephole here, but I'll say it again. Refers to a place. It is over there. Refers to possession. It is theirs. Refers to they are is a contraction for they are. They are very nice. That's when you see this little comma. That's a contraction. Like, can't is cannot. Won't is will not. Want not? Anyway, but you know what I mean? It's a contraction. The only one that doesn't follow this pattern, the only one that doesn't follow this pattern is it and its, or its and its. It's is it is. It is. So that's not possessive. It's it is. It's a contraction. It's is possessive. Like, it's its face, its hair, its whatever. So, just so you guys know that. That one I get mixed up on sometimes too, but there, there, and there, I'm literally done with you people. If you come up to me and you're mixing up there, and there, or your and your, like, you need help. You need help. And I'll even go through your and your, even though it's so self-explanatory. Oh no, actually, this one works the same way as it, its, and its. Your is possessive, no apostrophe, okay? Your, this is a contraction, you are. So you can say your house, or you are nice, or you're nice. Your house, you're nice. It's like your and your. And people mess that up all the time, and it's absolutely insane. Just remember that the apostrophe means it's a contraction. It means they took two words and put it into one, okay? It's literally not that hard. Like, it's not. It's not. Moving on to the one that absolutely drives me fucking insane, and I don't even know how people... I don't even know how people came up with this. They even put a big X next to it to show you that it's fucking wrong. And I'll write the proper one in huge letters so people can fucking get it. It is not should of. It's should have. Should have. If you come up to me saying should of, girl, you need help. You need to get help. Like, I'm sorry, but it's should have. Like, should of? Like, I'm sorry. Is it the should of hearts? The should of diamonds? The should of clubs? The should of spades? Is it the should of York? Is it, like... Like, once again, but I'm dumb. I'm dumb. I'm dumb, okay? Like, once again, I'll say it. If I'm dumb, I don't know what the hell is wrong with all of you, like, or anybody else. Like, if me stoopy, me big stoopy, then, like, I'm not prepared for this earth. I'm not ready for it. And then just some other little minor ones is... It's not all intensive purposes. It's all intents and purposes. Intents and purposes. Like intent for all intents and purposes. All intents and purposes. Not intensive purposes. Like, what's an intensive purpose? Like, it's like people don't think. And I haven't heard anybody say this one, but I... guess somebody else heard a lot of people saying it. It's disingenuous, not disingenuine, which I think is what I wrote on there. So if you see disingenuine, wrong. That's not right. It's disingenuous. Okay? Disingenuous. And once again, the dictionary.com app is free, completely free. And then you can look up words to even see if they are words. And then it has this absolutely groundbreaking, earth-shattering, life-changing feature where you click on this little microphone or this little, you know, thing, and it will say the word for you. It will pronounce the word for you. Sorry, like, it just gets so hard because it's like, I don't know, it just bugs the piss out of me when it's like people want to have an opinion on stuff and you literally exist on like a social platform. Like, y'all will be sending thousands of texts to each other but not know how to spell for shit. Like, what is that about? Like, I'm dead serious. Like, what is that about? Like, y'all literally have computers with spell check And like, yeah, I know that spell check doesn't always work, but like, once again, like we have things like literally shit like Google. Well, it's like Google it, brah. Like look it up. Like anyway, that was all. I if I think of more, because like that stuff really pisses me off. Because like, not to sound stupid, like I could understand not knowing a lot of those words if like you didn't encounter them very often, but like I just fail to see a reason why, you know, someone would like go through an entire true crime case about Adolfo Constanzo and never bother to learn how to pronounce Nganga correctly, you know? Or people, I've heard someone say, and I think it's just like, you know, they don't realize they're saying it wrong, but they say apparition instead of apparition, which I'm like, I don't want to be that person who's constantly correcting people, but it's like, you know, you would just sound more intelligent if you would pronounce things correctly. And like, here's my thing. I'm not trying to say that anybody who doesn't know this stuff is stupid, but maybe we should all consider that maybe if all of us actually learned this language that we use to communicate, then maybe we would be able to communicate more clearly with each other. If maybe, you know, because how many times have I seen people absolutely go off on something because they have no reading comprehension? Like people will literally read stuff wrong and then get mad because they think it says something it doesn't, and then look like a complete idiot. And it's like, did you know that 90% of your problems in life could be solved by learning how to read or write? Like, that's my thing. Like, I feel like we could actually solve more problems in the world if people would actually learn how to use this communication method properly. And I know that these are really like nitpicky kind of things, or they might seem nitpicky to other people, but I really don't think so, okay? Because if you get basic stuff like this wrong, like I'm not talking about Nganga, I'm not talking about heinous, you know, but I'm not talking about disingenuous, but if you get basic stuff wrong, like for example, people will get like common phrases of speech wrong where it's like that's not how the phrase goes, but okay. Like, but if you can't even understand all intents and purposes, or there and there, or your and your, like how am I trusting you to know what you're talking about literally anything else? Like I'm genuinely wondering. I'm not trying to say that anyone, like I said, if this is your second language, or you know, you have like some kind of learning disability, or you know, you have what's that one? Dyslexia. Okay, like that's different. You at least have a reason other than pure laziness and disinterest for not knowing these things or being challenged by these things. I am bothered by people who think they are so smart and they want to argue with me. And I'm not even kidding. Like someone last night oh my God, tried to say she should have done more research. And I literally responded, I'm like, you should have done more research in English class. And they responded with, well, she should have done more. And I'm just like, once again, it's should have, but I guess, you know, if you haven't learned that by now, I guess I'm the stupid one for expecting you to learn it that quickly. Like, I literally don't know at this point. And like, you know, and that's my thing is like, if you're gonna be out here calling people stupid and like having opinions about stuff, make sure that you don't sound like an absolute fucking dumbass yourself, okay? Like, if you're gonna be out here being a little keyboard warrior, maybe you should actually know how to spell a fucking word, okay? And like, I'm literally not even kidding. It takes two seconds, two whole seconds to literally switch out of your one app that you're going the fuck off in and like, go to the dictionary.com app and make sure that it's a real word or that you're using it correctly. Like, and okay, here's my thing. I understand getting words mixed up if they sound the same. You know, I still am struggling to figure out lay and lie. That shit, I like that. There's some things in English where, you know, English doesn't make sense. Okay. It doesn't make sense. It really is not a very logical language, but basic communication to me is important because I feel like, you know, most of the reason why people don't either, like, I don't know, they're it's funny to me because, like, I'm supposedly the socially awkward one, but whenever I talk to other people and they're, like, struggling to, like, keep up a conversation or even, like, you know, struggling to even, like, pretend like they're interested, but I have to all the time, but I'm the socially awkward, like, you are acting, like, you are the one making this awkward. Like, you are the one making this awkward. So, like, I don't know. And it just bugs me, like, you know, I work with a bunch of, like, college-age kids, which they're fine. I don't have anything against college kids. I do have something against college kids that are kind of dumb. Like, because that's what gets to me is, like, how are you in college? And you don't know this basic stuff. Like, it's kind of like when I was in high school. And there were some kids, like, literally I was a senior in high school. And these kids in the same grade as me. Seniors in high school, and we're literally trying to just, like, read, and it wasn't even hard, it was, like, easy. It'd be like if I was like, the dog went to the park, and this guy sitting there going, the dog went to, I'm like, bro, teacher, stop calling on them, like, stop calling on that person. And they were like, they were a super popular kid too, by the way, and a football player. So I think we can all figure out how they even got this far in school. Probably because all of the stupid fucking, you know, teachers that doubled as coaches, they were like, oh yeah, I'm a science teacher and a coach. It's like, okay, so then you're just going to pass all the guys on your team because, you know, they're on your team, but, like, kids like me who don't give a fuck about that, who, like, are actually intelligent but just don't do their homework, like, you, because they're not stupid enough to just do what any, like, authority figure that walks in the room tells them to do. Right, I'm the dumb one. I'm me, stupid. Like, so if I'm so angry, it's not because I'm mad at any person in particular. It's just because this is, like, a huge pet peeve for me. And I just don't know how people go their whole lives without, like, because my thing is like, I sit here saying, oh, I wonder if I'm saying this right. I don't want to seem like an idiot. I better go look at it. Like, do people not have that thought? Like, I guess I do because I've been called stupid so many times that I'm like, I better not get it wrong or someone's going to call me stupid, you know? So it's like, I guess y'all just weren't bullied enough. Like, I guess y'all just weren't called stupid enough to actually make you worry about coming across as really fucking stupid. Like, I don't know. And like I said, you know, if you actually have a good reason for why you struggle with this stuff, good for you. I'm not saying you're an idiot. If you have no good reason for why you struggle with this stuff, and it's just because, you know, all you do all day is play video games and play football and text your little friends, like, that's on you. That is your fault. It's not my fault you're stupid. It's your fault. Okay? Everybody else, thank you for watching. I hope that this enriched your life. I hope that you will start saying words correctly. I hope that you will take pleasure in words. I hope that you will see that this thing, beautiful thing we have, this beautiful language is beautiful, and that you will have more respect for the language, more respect for grammar, and more respect for your own intelligence. That's what I need people to start doing also, is just have more respect for your own intelligence, okay? Like, because by, like, when you say stuff, like, I don't know, like, when you, I don't know, it's just like when you go along with stuff that is so basic and just, like, or even, like, films and media that, like, you only like it because it's popular, or you only think it's good because you don't know how cliche it is, or you don't seem to realize that these companies don't actually care about you as a person. They're literally using these films and movies and shows and media and games to take your money. They don't have any respect for you or your intelligence, okay? You need to have respect for yourself and your own intelligence. Stop, like, research what an actual, like, good story is, you know? Research stuff that you read online. Like, don't just go around spreading misinformation. Don't go around just saying that anything is good just because, you know, it's like a big company made it. Like, that's what I don't understand. Like, please have more respect for your own intelligence. Like, because seriously, that's the only way anything is going to get solved in this world, because I am so sick of people living in a state of ignorant bliss. Like, because that's what it is at this point. Like, at this point, if you're completely satisfied with the world and you think everything's fine, you are ignorant, okay? So, I don't know. It's just like, and that's my thing too. Like, half the time I feel like people only enjoy, like, popular media so much because they are ignorant to, like, what actually goes into creating that media. They are ignorant as to what a cliche is. They're ignorant as to, you know, what actually, like I said, what actually goes into making these movies. Half the time, it's a bunch of people sitting in a meeting saying, well, we did this last time, so that made more money. Like, do you realize that people are literally, like, looking at your buying habits, looking at your viewing habits, and saying, we can exploit this person for more money by giving them what they want. It doesn't even have to be original, and they'll just eat it up. That's where we get into this cycle of we never have any new movies. We only have sequels to old movies that they already know are popular. Like, does this not occur to anybody else? Like, you are being exploited. You are being called stupid in the most subversive way possible. Like, these people are taking your hard-earned money for something that they put zero effort into. Please go and look and research actual art. Look at and research actual art. Read real books. Read books that are written by good authors, not just popular authors, okay? Like, read enough books until you figure out by reading a book whether it is written well or written terribly. It's so insane to me how so many people can be avid readers. Well, clearly you're not, because you have no reading comprehension. You have no cognitive ability to, like, assess whether this story is well written or is literal verbal trash. Like, educate yourself about grammar, word usage, you know, educate yourself so that, like, I don't know. It's just like, oh man. And I'll give you an example. The Twilight series. I know. I'm sorry. It's terribly written. It's written so horribly. And the sheer fact that, like, so many people are basically obsessed with what is essentially, like, glorified fan fiction. And that even makes me uncomfortable to say, because there is fan fiction out there that is written better than this. That's why I have a hard time. Like, I look at things that are popular and, like, I get, like, having a guilty pleasure or something, but, like, I don't know, like, not to sound stupid, like, I like Britney Spears, but, like, she was actually good. You know, like, some popular things are actually good. You know, like, so, but I don't understand this whole thing of, like, I don't know. Like, that's what gets to me, is, like, people seem to think that whatever's the most popular opinion or whatever's the most popular whatever, it's, like, infallible and, you know, can never be wrong and never be bad. It's like, let me blow your absolute minds right now. As someone who was bullied literally from, like, kindergarten into college by popular kids, something being popular doesn't make it good. I'll say it again. Something being popular doesn't make it good. And that includes social media, people, opinions, movies. Yeah, it really kind of counts for anything. Just because something is celebrities, just because something is popular, doesn't mean it's morally correct or right or infallible or perfect in any way. Okay? Thank you for opening up your brains for me today. Thank you. I wish you all the best in your endeavors. Wish you all the best. All right. Pearls.